CMS founder Dr. Jagdish Gandhi has been motivating parents and generations of good and smart children through holding special prayer assemblies and divine education conferences.
Dear friends, I am a man of education. Education is the most powerful weapon which you can use to change the world. The world requires the change.
Dear children, you are in a very good school. You are very lucky to be studying in a school which is trying to make you both good and smart. Good means good qualities. And what are the good qualities? That have been sent by one God in different holy books, in Bhagavad Gita, in Tripitaka, in Bible, in Quran, in Guru Granth Sahib, in Kitab-e-Aqdas, in Kitab-e-Ajab-e-Ista. There are many holy books, revealed books of God. So the teachings which have come from God, they are useful teachings for us. They make us, make our life sublime. They give us the direction, what is the right way and how to move in our life, what to do and what not to do. This gives you knowledge about life, how to conduct our life. So, knowing the teachings of God and then wisdom is to act upon those teachings. You become good. If you know the teachings of God and act upon the teachings of God, you are good. So this branch, this campus especially is trying to make you good. That means with good qualities of life that have been sent by one God from time to time, from place to place. So they are giving you all sort of good qualities, the godly qualities God has sent, and then making you smart. You are already smart, but first of all you should become good and then smart. If you are both good and smart, you are a balanced human being. And if you are a balanced human being, you will become a gift of God to mankind. You will become a pride of the human race. You will become a potential light of the world. So this branch is making you good and smart, a gift of God to mankind, a pride of the human race, and a potential light of the world. Dear children, you just said a prayer. The prayer says, I bear witness, O my God, that thou hast created me to know thee and to worship thee. You have created me for two things. Number one, to know thee. And number two, to worship thee. Knowing thee, thee means God. Knowing thee means, how do we know God? We cannot see him. We cannot meet him. We cannot talk to him. We cannot find him anywhere. We cannot touch him. Then how should we know it? But this is the purpose in life. And how to worship? Where to go for worship? He is not seen anywhere. So dear children, knowing God means knowing the thoughts of God, the ideas of God, the vision of God, the teachings of God. They are the teachings which are available in these holy books, in Bhagavad Gita, in Tripitaka, in Bible, in Quran, in Guru Granth Sahib, in Bhai Kitab-e-Aqdas. These are the teachings. So knowing these teachings means knowing God. My purpose in life is to know God. How do we know God? What kind of God is? What are his thoughts? What are his ideas? What is his vision? We know all these things from these books. So knowing God means knowing his ideas, knowing his teachings. You may call them ideas, you may call them teachings, you may call them anything. The vision of God. Knowing God means knowing his life. This is his life. He lives for this, for teaching these values to the mankind. So this is, knowing God means knowing these teachings of God. And then worshipping God. How do we worship God? The only way to worship God is to obey his teachings. to act upon the teachings. This is the wisdom of a man. Knowing these teachings is the knowledge of God. Knowledge of the teachings of God means knowledge of God. And what is the wisdom of a man? Who is wise? Who acts upon these teachings. Who brings these teachings into practical life. Practice. So dear children, knowing the teachings of God and then act upon the teachings of God or obeying the teachings of God is the worship of God, and this is precisely the reason for which God has created man. When God made this earth and sun and the moon and the sky and the earth and you know the air and water and everything, he created animals also. Like cow he created so that she can give milk and a man can have milk. Buffalo and then, you know, so many things God has created for men. And then God finally created man. He created Adam and Eve. First of all, he created a family, a husband and a wife. He has not created single man or single woman. He created two and he made them husband and wife. So he created a miniature form of society. He wanted that his society, his family should become bigger and bigger and bigger. So he made a plan that create husband and wife and let them be a children so there will be more people, and then these children will become elder and they will get married and they will get children. So likewise there will be many people on the earth. That is what he wanted. And he has arranged for food and everything. In this earth you can find wheat, rice, so much of, you know, fruits, vegetables, everything is there inside the land. So God has created all these godowns for the use of man. So dear children, God has created all this for man, and God wanted his family to grow and as many people as possible, and he has arranged for everyone. Air and water and fruits and, you know, food and everything he has created. But then he also gave them the teaching because God wanted his children to be happy. He is a creator. Any father who brings children to this earth wants their happiness. Even the mortal father wants their happiness. Our mother father, your mother father, they also want our happiness. So God is our heaven, God is our father in heaven. He created us. He wants us to see us happy. So for happiness, he has sent his guidance. He gave the guidance to Adam and Eve. And that was the first guidance he gave us, that the only way to be happy, to be prosperous, to be healthy, to be successful in life, is to know my teachings, know me and worship me. Know my teachings and act upon those teachings. That will make you happy. That will make you successful in life. That will make you a great man. That will make you a famous man. That will make you anything that you want to become. The only way is to know my teachings and obey my teachings. So this was the first lesson God gave to Adam and Eve. And this was the religion. He said, this is your religion. Religion is duty. This is your duty. This is your religion. To know me and to worship me. To know my teachings and to obey my teachings. And he instructed them that now I have given birth to both of you. I have created you husband and wife. Now your children will come. You give them the same, this my teaching to them, my hidden words to them, that they should, for their happiness, know my teachings and obey on my teachings. Obey my teachings. Act upon my teachings. And tell them that they should tell their children the same, the principle of religion. Religion means duty. This duty to know the Creator and to love the Creator. To know the Creator, teachings of the Creator, and to obey the teachings of the Creator, tell them. So, पीढ़ी दर पीढ़ी ये बात आप अपने बच्चों को बताएं, आपके उनके जो बच्चे होंगे वो अपने बच्चों को बताएं, फिर जो उनके बच्चे होंगे उनको बताएं, ताकि सृष्टि पर सभी सुखी हों, सभी आनंदित हों, सभी सफल हों और सभी जीवन में महान बने। तो ये ज्ञान परमात्मा ने जब ये सृष्टि बनाई और जब एडम रीव को बनाया तो वो ज्ञान दिया, वो धर्म बताया, और वो धर्म आज तक न कभी बदला है न कभी बदलेगा। धर्म शाश्वत है, अपरिवर्तनीय है, न कभी बदलता है न कभी बदलेगा। तो धर्म तो बदलता नहीं, धर्म माने कर्तव्य, और कर्तव्य एक ही है प्राणी का, प्रभु की इच्छाओं को आज्ञाओं को जानना, ये सब एक प्रभु की आज्ञा है और इन पर चलना, इसके अलावा कोई दूसरा धर्म नहीं है। बाकी तो क्या है कि रिचुअल्स हैं, या तो अज्ञानता है, डार्कनेस ऑफ इग्नोरेंस है। ये जितना भी है, लोग कहते हैं धर्म अलग अलग हैं, रास्ते अलग अलग हैं, मंदिर एक है। अरे भाई, मंदिर भी एक है और रास्ता भी एक ही है। रास्ता क्या है? इन आज्ञाओं को जानना, गीता कुरान बाइबल गुरु ग्रंथ साहब में जो शिक्षाएं दी हैं उनको जानना, उनको चलना। अब आज से 7,500 वर्ष पूर्व राम आए धरती पर, और भगवान राम को कोई पुस्तक तो नहीं मिली, तो तुलसीदास जी ने उनके ऊपर एक पुस्तक लिखी। तुलसीदास जी का 500 वर्ष पूर्व जन्म हुआ, राम तो 7,500 वर्ष पूर्व धरती पर आए थे। आज जब जन्म हुआ तो हर जगह वो एक ही बात सुनते, राम की महिमा, राम की चर्चा, राम के गीत, जहाँ भी देखो जय श्री राम जय श्री राम, राम धुन हर जगह। तो उन्होंने कहा कि ये राम थे कौन, उन्होंने उनकी जानकारी की। वो गांव गांव गए, चारों तरफ गए और लोगों से पूछा कि राम के बारे में और कोई किस्सा बताइए। लोगों ने उनके बारे में उनकी किस्से और कहानियाँ जो 7,500 वर्ष पूर्व आए थे वो किंवदंतियों के जरिए कि राम का जीवन ऐसा था, वो सब अपने बच्चों को बताया करते थे पीढ़ी दर पीढ़ी। तो उन्होंने इकट्ठा किया था और इकट्ठा करके दोहे लिखे और छंद लिखे और ये रामायण तैयार कर दिया। तो रामचंद्र जी थे वो एक अवतार थे, इन्हें लेकिन हिंदू धर्म में अर्ध अवतार मानते हैं, क्योंकि पूर्ण अवतार उसको मानते हैं जिसे परमात्मा कोई दिव्य पुस्तक यानी कंप्लीट सेट ऑफ स्पिरिचुअल लॉज रिवील करें। तो इनको तो केवल एक परमात्मा ने आज्ञा दी कि मानव जीवन को मर्यादित करो, और इन्होंने मर्यादा का पालन किया। अपने पिता के वचन की मर्यादा के पालन के लिए 14 वर्ष के लिए वनवास चले, अपार कष्ट झेले, वन में बहुत विपत्तियां भी आई, सब झेला इन्होंने, लेकिन मर्यादा का पालन किया, वचन की मर्यादा। तो प्यारे बच्चों, ये कहलाए मर्यादा पुरुषोत्तम भगवान श्री राम, और ये पूज्य हैं क्योंकि भगवान के अवतार थे, अर्ध अवतार हैं। लेकिन इनके चले जाने के बाद, इनकी मृत्यु के 2,500 वर्ष के बाद, यानी आज से 5,000 वर्ष पूर्व भगवान श्री कृष्ण का आगमन होता है। ये जितने अवतार होते हैं डिवाइन मिस्ट्री होते हैं, परमात्मा की एक दिव्य रहस्य होते हैं। ये बचपन से ही इनके अंदर ऐसे गुण होते हैं जो सामान्य पुरुषों में नहीं होते हैं। ये बचपन से ही इनकी अजीब गाथाएं होती हैं, अजीब लीलाएं होती हैं, और वो दिव्य लीलाएं होती हैं, इसको कोई समझ नहीं सकता है। तो ये दिव्य प्रकाश होते हैं। तो इनका जन्म 5,000 वर्ष पूर्व हुआ और इनकी आत्मा में प्रकाश आया, और वो था गीता का प्रकाश, और वो एक संवाद के रूप में है। अर्जुन के प्रश्न हो रहे हैं और भगवान के उत्तर हो रहे हैं, और कृष्ण उसके माध्यम बने, जैसे कोई बांसुरी में गीत गा रहा हो और बांसुरी में से कोई सुनने वाला सुन रहा है। तो बांसुरी का उसमें इतना ही योगदान है कि तो गीत को वहां तक ले जाती है। गीत तो भगवान का है, तो ऐसे गीत तो भगवान ने गाया, गीता का गीत, और सुनने वाला था अर्जुन, और किसके माध्यम से आया? भगवान कृष्ण की पवित्र आत्मा के माध्यम से। उस युग की अति पवित्र आत्मा भगवान कृष्ण थे, परमात्मा ने स्वयं उनको सृजित किया था, और जो परमात्मा सृजित करता है वो पवित्रतम होता है। तो ये परमात्मा का सृजन था, ये पवित्र आत्मा थे, इनके माध्यम से ये प्रकाश आया। अब भगवान के पास, भगवान का क्या है, भगवान परमात्मा ईश्वर जो भी आप कहें, खुदा अल्लाह, उसका कोई शरीर नहीं होता, वो आत्म तत्व रूह है, वो आत्मा है और कण कण में व्याप्त है, वो हवा में है, पानी में है, पेड़ में है, पौधों में है, वो ऐसी कोई जगह नहीं है जहाँ परमात्मा न हो, ऊपर भी है, नीचे भी है, बाएं भी है, दाहिने भी है, पीछे भी है, आगे भी है, वो हर जगह है।
यह थे सिटी मोंटेसोरी स्कूल के संस्थापक प्रबंधक एवं प्रख्यात शिक्षाविद डॉक्टर जगदीश गांधी, जिनका मानना है आज मानव जाति को जय जगत के नारे को बुलंद करने की आवश्यकता है तथा विश्व में वास्तविक शांति लाने के लिए बच्चे ही सबसे सशक्त माध्यम है। छात्रों, शिक्षकों व अभिभावकों के मार्गदर्शन हेतु डॉक्टर जगदीश गांधी द्वारा लिखित पुस्तकें साहित्य भारती इंटरनेशनल, न्यूमन ग्रुप, 4C अंसारी रोड, दरियागंज, नई दिल्ली 110002 से प्राप्त की जा सकती हैं। Heal the world with the power of Jai Jagat, City Montessori School since 1959 has been actively working to construct the defenses of peace in the minds of students, for which CMS in the year 2002 was awarded with the UNESCO Prize for Peace Education. CMS education revolves around the twin poles of godliness and globalism through four pillars of education, namely universal values, excellence in all things, global understanding, and service to humanity.
We for. प्यारे बच्चों, सबसे पहले तो मैं इन बच्चों को बधाई दूंगा, बच्चों को बहुत बहुत बधाइयाँ और इनके टीचर्स को बधाइयाँ, इनकी बड़ी दीदियों को बधाइयाँ, टीचर गार्जियंस को बधाइयाँ जिन्होंने बच्चों के साथ परिश्रम किया, और बच्चों को सबसे ज़्यादा बधाई जिन्होंने बहुत परिश्रम किया है और बड़ी मेहनत से ये उपलब्धि प्राप्त की है। साथ ही मैं सभी पेरेंट्स को भी बधाई देना चाहता हूँ जिनके भी योगदान से ये अचीवमेंट हुआ है। ये हिंदुस्तान का सबसे बढ़िया रिजल्ट है, पूरे देश का, पूरे देश में सबसे अच्छा रिजल्ट है, और पूरे इंडिया में भी हमारी मेरिट में 3 बच्चों का आना इंटरमीडिएट में और 2 बच्चे फर्स्ट और सेकंड यूपी में आए हैं। तो ये फर्स्ट भी हमारा ICSE में, सेकंड भी हमारा, और साथ ही साथ इंडिया में आप देखें इंटरमीडिएट में सेकंड, थर्ड और फोर्थ तीनों रैंक CMS को मिली है। तो ये एक बहुत बड़ी उपलब्धि है।
एनी स्पेशल थिंग ऑफ CMS दैट यू हैव टेकन विद यू इन योर लाइफ?
That CMS is a very good institution for a student to create his or her career.
So I'm Gurbani Bedi, Gomti Nagar 1, CMS.
Okay. What percentage did you secure?
94%.
94. Congratulations for achieving this percentage. How did you manage to score this percentage?
I don't know. CMS is pretty good and they prepare us themselves. and I had support from my parents, and I have an elder sister, and she kind of guided me on what to do and what not to do, and yeah.
Did you really expect it out of you?
I knew that I could get 90% and above, and I just, yeah.
Who would you like to give the credit of your success to?
My parents and my teachers and God, obviously, yeah.
How have the teachers, teacher guardians helped you in your school?
The subject teachers have helped us quite a lot. They've guided us, they've given us what questions are important, what are not important. And teacher guardians have also, my teacher guardian, I'd like to thank her a lot, because she prepared a timetable for me and she told me that you have to follow this and I have to study this much hours a day, that definitely I cannot skip. So yeah, she helped quite a lot. Teachers helped quite a lot, yeah.
Which subject was a great fear to you?
Chemistry.
And how did you plan to overcome that fear?
I don't know, just studying. I think I studied chemistry more than I've studied any other subject. And yeah, I think that is the only way you can overcome. I mean, if you have to put in greater effort than you will in the other subjects.
Any special thing of CMS that you would like to quote here?
Yeah, I mean, they prepare us themselves, and they have comparatives and they have pre-boards, and the teachers are quite good, and the checking, the way they check the papers is also good. They prepare us for the boards, and I think even in class 8th or class 7th, we are being prepped up for the boards exam. So yeah, that's good.
Do you think the prior comparatives and the pre-board examinations held by CMS helps the students to achieve this percentage?
Yeah, of course. I mean, I think 20% of what I've scored is that only, because I think if you keep on giving exams again and again, you are forced to study. Even if you don't want to study, you have to study because you have an exam. And yeah, so basically it helps us.
You must have heard the words of Dr. Jagdish Gandhi and Dr. Bharti Gandhi. So what learning did you get from them?
They've always supported us, and they've helped us realize that we have the potential in us and that there's nothing we can't do if we try. So yeah, they've prepped us a lot, and they've cheered us up when we've not been able to do our best. And they've always made us feel that you can do it, and it's not, you know, you don't have to be very special to do it, you can do it. I mean, even the most ordinary of people can do it, so yeah.
Any message for 2018 boards appearing students?
I mean, just, you'll obviously be very scared when you'll be appearing for it, but like my mother told me, that it's just a normal examination. You know, the hype around, there's too much hype surrounding it, the boards exam, but they're normal examinations. And if you do not feel the fear, I think you'll be able to do much better.
Please introduce yourself.
My name is Kushi Agarwal, and I am an ICSC student, got 93.4%.
Congratulations. And which branch are you from?
I'm from Gomtinagar Campus 1.
How did you manage to score this percentage?
Actually, it was a bit difficult, but through regular studies and through comparatives and pre-boards which our school conducted, it was really very helpful, so that we could practice, and that's the secret.
So what was your schedule for studying during your board examinations?
Actually, there was not fixed schedule. Basically, it depends on my mood. If I would feel that yes, I could study 4 chapters within 4 hours, then I would study. And if I need breaks, basically I studied not for long. I took breaks and then studied, like 30 minutes break or 15 minutes break. That's.
How did you manage your pre-exam stress?
Pre-exam stress, that was just my mother. She helped me a lot in that. And through my teacher, I would really thank my class teacher, who helped me a lot in order to overcome this stress.
And which subject was a great fear to you?
Great fear for me, it was mathematics. Though I scored very well in comparatives and pre-board, but then too I was very very scared in mathematics, because I thought that if you mistake just a point mistake also it comes, then the answer is wrong. Therefore the fear was mathematics.
You must have heard the words of Dr. Jagdish Gandhi speaking up in all the events. So what learning did you get it from them?
Basically, his speaking were very, very helpful for me. Actually, he motivated us that not only scoring in board exams is important, basically learning is important, and that was the main goal.
How did the teachers and the teacher guardians help you in your school to achieve this percentage?
Basically, teachers, teacher guardians, they were just like friends. And any doubt, any query, you can call them, you can message them at any time. Whether in boards also, if we were having any query, at late night also, at 12 o'clock also, then also they were there for us. I would really thank them because they were there at every moment. And this is how they helped us. Basically, they helped us how to explaining of the chapter was made very easy by them. That's
it. Please introduce yourself.
I'm Keshav Kapoor from class 10, Station Road campus.
And what percentage did you secure?
94.8.
94.8, congratulations for achieving this percentage. How did you manage to score this percentage?
Ma'am, studies and enjoyment a lot, but ma'am, studies mainly. But important studies like enrichment classes and self-studies.
So that. What was your strategy for studying and tracking this board examination?
Smart studies, ma'am, told by school teachers and founder manager Jagdish Gandhi sir. So ma'am, smart studies and sure success provided by all the teachers and assistants also. So ma'am, it all helped us together.
So do you think, is it hard work or smart work that pays more?
Smart work.
Smart work. So any message for 2018 boards appearing student?
I'll just say that just do your best, be confident, do smart, do hard as well, but do smart mainly. Just be confident.
Have heard the words of Dr. Jagdish Gandhi. So did you get any learning from it?
Yes ma'am, spiritual learning, inspiration, everything. It also helps us to imbibe good virtues in ourselves. So ma'am, it's good.
Any special thing of CMS that you have imbibed in yourself, in your life?
The motto itself says it, Jai Jagat. So ma'am, it's all in that motto only. That healing the whole world, Jai Jagat, and respecting everyone, healing the world and being good to everyone. And ma'am, the three virtues, God is one, man is one, and all the religions are one. So it all helps us to be good.
So this was the first time you appeared for the board examinations. Was any subject a great fear to you?
Biology.
Biology. And how did you try to overcome that fear?
My teachers are very nice. They helped me a lot in that. Biology, my teachers helped me in enrichment classes, in classes. Whenever I had any problem, I could call them, they could help me there also. And ma'am, sure success also helped me, past year papers, everything together made it nice.
So how did the teachers helped you?
Teachers were always ready to help me. They were like, you just call me, you just ask me whenever and whatever the time is. I can help you anywhere, anytime. They were always ready.
Shikshatmak सांस्कृतिक कार्यक्रम एवं चिंतन हेतु विश्व एकता सत्संग में आप सभी सपरिवार सादर आमंत्रित हैं।